Hello everyone, let us start solving problems on pin jointed trusses by unit load method. So already we have discussed the procedure to find the deflection in pin jointed trusses in the beginning while discussing about the unit load method. Let us discuss the steps again such that it is easy for you to find the deflection. So you will need to find the reactions at supports for applied external force. Then in step one, then compute the axial force P in various members due to the applied external force by using method of joints or method of sections in second step. Then find the reactions and compute the axial force that is K in various members due to unit load applied in the direction of required deflection of the point. Remove all the external loads and apply unit load. So compute the product. So the deflection is PKL by AE for all the members, where P is the forces in each members due to the externally applied load. The K is the forces in the each member due to unit load. Then L is the length of the member, A is the cross-sectional area of each member, and E is the Young's modulus of the member. Okay, so then summation delta for the all the members, if you add them, so for the entire truss will be getting the deflection. So then axial forces shall be taken as positive if tensile and negative if compressive. Okay, so just remember these steps and we'll go ahead one by one the steps in solving the problems. So just check it once again. So what are the things you are going to do? So step one, so you will apply the external load and you will find what will be the forces in the members of the truss due to the application of external load. So in all the members, if you find, that is P, correct? Yeah, this is P due to the externally applied load. So forces in each members, that is P. So then again, you need to remove all the loads and apply unit force in the direction where the deflection is required. Then again find all the forces in the members of the truss by applying unit load, and it will be called as K. Okay, P is the forces in the members of the truss due to the externally applied load, and K is the forces in the members of the truss due to the unit force. Okay, then delta is given by the product P into K into L divided by AE for each individual member. For the entire truss, it is summation of PKL by AE. Tensile forces considered as positive and compressive forces will be considered as negative. Okay, so let us go to the problem. So here already we have discussed what is truss and what are the assumptions made in the truss and how to find the forces in the members of the truss by method of joints and by method of sections in case of rolling loads, influence diagrams, or else in case of strain energy method, again in case of Cashley-Lewis method. Already we have discussed this. Okay, how to find the forces in the members of the truss. You can use the method of joints and method of sections. Here I will be concentrating on only the procedure. So finding the forces in the members of the truss, so it is easy, so you can do this. Okay, so let us look into the statement. The cross sectional area of each member of the truss shown in figure is 400 mm² and E is 200 GPa gigapascal. So determine the vertical deflection of joint C if a 4 kN force is applied to the truss at C. Okay, so this is a pin jointed truss with three members, AB, BC and AC. There are three members in this truss and they have given the dimensions of these members. AB dimension is 8 meters. Okay, then this height is from here to here, so it is 3 meters. Okay, so you can calculate this angle. So if this is 3, this is 4, if this is 90 degrees, so this will be 5, correct? So even this will be 5, so this angle you can find out. Okay, so first you need to identify all the dimensions of the members and angles. If either you can start with method of joints or method of sections, where you will be requiring the angles. Correct. So here they have given the areas, okay, in mm square. Yes. So one more thing, what we need to keep it in mind here. So it's better to keep all the things, the lengths in mm, okay, in that tabular column ultimately, and load in kilonewton. Okay, load in kilonewton and length in mm. If you see the strain energy method, Castellanos method, and also here, so it's better to keep the forces in kilonewton and the lengths in mm. Okay, so here they are asked us to calculate a vertical deflection of joint C. So at C, vertical deflection, okay, due to the application of load. So what is the load here? External load, that is 4 kilonewton. So you will be finding what are the forces in the members of the truss by method of joints and method of sections. The second step, you need to remove this, okay, then you need to apply the vertical 1 kilonewton load. Okay, so due to this 1 kilonewton load, what will be the forces in the members of the truss? Again, you need to find it. Okay, so let us discuss this. So step one, to find the reactions. So this 4 kilonewton, this is due to the external force. So here we are applying the external force. Due to external force, what will be the forces in the members of the truss by method of joints or method of sections we are doing? So for that reason, the method of joints, if you start with, then first you need to find the reactions. Using your equilibrium conditions, apply sigma H is equal to 0. So here 4 kilonewton is there, here HA is there. Ultimately, you will be getting HA as minus 4 kilonewton. HA is nothing but it is acting leftwards. Then take moment about any particular point as 0. So due to, if you take moment about B equal to 0, RA into 8 meters, then this 4 into 3 meters. This side is perpendicular distance is 3 meters. So you will be getting RA as 1.5 kilonewton. Correct. So once you get RA, then apply sigma Y equal to 0 or sigma V equal to 0, RA plus RB equal to 0, because there is no vertical force acting in this truss. So ultimately RB will be 1.5, opposite direction to RA. Okay. So RA is downwards, so RB will be upwards. So ultimately summation of V should be equal to 0. So once you find the reactions, then you need to start with method of joints. So how to find? So first find this angle, because when you consider a FBD of a joint, so for inclined members, you need to resolve the forces. Okay. So this is 3 meters. This is 4 meters. So tan theta is opposite divided by adjacent. So 3 by 4. Theta is tan inverse of 0.75. You will be getting 36.86. So this theta you are getting 36.86. So now method of joints, you need to consider a joint where there are only 2 unknown member forces acting. Correct. So if you consider joint A, the reactions are known. So this force and this force, they are unknown. Force in the member AC is unknown. Force in the member AC dash here, okay, AC is unknown. Okay, so you can say the force in the member AB is unknown, force in the member AC is unknown. Okay, first we need to find this. So then you can consider joint B. Then again, this is already known. So force in the member BC can be found. So all the 3 members forces will be known to us. So consider joint A. So assume the unknown forces, that is force in the member AC, force in the member AB as tensile first. Then resolve the force and apply sigma H is equal to 0, sigma V equal to 0. So ultimately you will be getting what will be the forces in the members. AC, it is 2.5 kilonewton tensile. AB, it is 2 kilonewton tensile. Both are positive. Okay. So two unknowns, two equations. Sigma H is equal to 0, sigma V equal to 0. Okay. So then againly, consider one more joint, FBD of a joint, free body diagram of a joint, where there are two unknowns maximum. Already BA is known, so which is tensile. So only thing unknown is BC. So assume that tensile. So in the beginning, so resolve the force and ultimately we'll be getting this as minus 2.5, nothing but it is compressive, 2.5 kilonewton compressive load. So you have found what all the forces in the members of the truss. 3 members were there, so you have found all the 3 member forces due to the externally applied load. What is the external load here? 4 kilonewton. So similarly, in next step, So you need to find the forces in the members of the truss by application of unit force, that is 1 kilonewton, in the direction of deflection, where the deflection is required about that particular point. So to find the reactions for virtual force or unit load, 1 kilonewton at C. So actually there is no load, but we are assuming it, so it is virtual force. So at point C, okay, where the deflection is required, vertical deflection is required, so we are applying vertical 1 kilonewton. So in terms of 1 kilonewton, find what will be the reactions. HA will be 0 because the only load present here now is 1 kilonewton. There are no other loads. That 4 kilonewton we have removed. We are applying only 1 kilonewton. So HA is 0. So if you take moment over B equal to 0, then you will be getting RA dash. It is 0.5 kilonewton. So it is symmetrical load ultimately. So 4 meters here, 4 meters here. Both the reactions will be 0.5, 0.5. Correct? So this is also 0.5. Both are upwards. Correct? So now again consider method of joints or method of section, so whichever you are comfortable. So find what all the forces in the members of the truss, like how we have done here. Consider joint A, consider joint B, and find what will be the forces in the members of the truss due to the 1 kilonewton load. Okay, so now this tabular column is important. So this tabular column is very much important. So that is step 5. Compute the product delta for all the members. So there are 3 members, AB, BC and AC. The length of the members we are keeping in mm. So 8 meters was there, 8000 mm, 5000 mm, 5000 mm. So areas in mm square they have given 400, 400, 400. All are having same cross sectional area. Then Young's modulus, so it was 200 GPa. Correct? So that is giga Pascal. So then it is 200, 200, 200 in terms of kilonewton per mm square. Yes. Then load, that is P. This is what? Due to the external load. Correct. So that is 4 kilonewton was acting at point B. Correct. So due to that 4 kilonewton load, so what are the forces in the members of the truss? So in AB, it is 2 kilonewton tensile. So in BC, it is 2.5 kilonewton compression. Then in AC it is 2.5 tensile. So similarly, this K, this is due to unit load, that is 1 kilonewton. Correct? When you applied 1 kilonewton, so that time whatever the load we are getting in all the members, this is 0.667 minus 0.833 minus 0.833 here only, whatever we have found due to the application of 1 kilonewton. So what will be the forces in the members? So ultimately delta is in each member PKL divided by AE. Delta will be, now it is in terms of mm, because we have kept length in mm, area in mm, even Young's modulus, kilonewton per mm square. Correct? So you will be getting the delta mm. So AB it is 0.1334, BC it is 0.130, AC it is minus 0.130. So ultimately for the entire truss, so the deflection, vertical deflection at the point B, so here they have asked, so here at the point C, yes, so here what is the vertical displacement? We have assumed the load downwards, so ultimately we are getting this as delta summation. If you add all the 3 members, that is delta is 0.1334 mm. So this 0.130 minus 0.130, it get cancelled. So you are left out with 0.1334 mm vertical deflection. You are getting positive, means it is downwards only, 0.1334 mm. Correct? So this tabular column is important. Okay, so this P is due to the external load, whatever is acting on the trusses, all the forces in the members of the truss by method of joints or method of sections. Area will be given, the lengths, sometimes all the lengths will be given or few lengths will be given, you need to find the remaining. Then Young's modulus will be given. So if not, in terms of U only, you can substitute. This K is the forces in the members of the truss by application of unit force, that is 1 kilonewton. Okay, so this is the standard formula. So PKL divided by AE, for the entire truss. So summation of PKL by AE. I hope it is clear. This is how you will solve the truss problem to find the vertical deflection or horizontal deflection, anything. Okay, suppose if it is asked to find the horizontal deflection, so you should be applying the horizontal 1 kN where it is required. Correct. So let us just see the procedure in one more truss problem. So determine the vertical deflection of joint E for the Warren truss shown in figure. Take area 645 mm² and Young's modulus 200 kN/mm² for all the members. For all the members, area is constant and E is so kN/mm². So it is also in mm, it is also in mm. So whatever the member length you are going to calculate, that should be also in mm. You need to keep it in mm only. Okay, so they are asking us to find the vertical deflection of joint E. So joint E is here. So vertical deflection means, so vertically deflected either downwards or upwards. So we need to assume here 1 kN vertically. First step, due to the external load, what will be the forces in the members of the truss? Total how many members are there? AB 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Total 7 members. In all the 7 members, due to 3 kN, what will be the forces? So since this 3 kN is symmetrical load from 2.5 meters, okay, so you will get the reactions equally 1.5 1.5. RA is 1.5, RD is 1.5, HA, since it is hinge support, so one more horizontal reaction, HA will be 0. There is no horizontal load acting on this particular truss. So if you find the reactions, so 1.5 RA, 1.5 RD. Okay, so if this is 60 degrees, this is 60 degrees, even this will be 60 degrees. So equilateral triangle, 60, 60, this is also 60. So even this is 60, this is 60, all will be 60, 60, 60. Okay, so by method of joints, you can start with the finding the forces in the members. So due to the external load, so nothing but it is P, correct, capital P. So consider joint A, 2 unknown member forces, assume the unknown member forces, tensile forces, and go ahead with the procedure. Apply sigma H is equal to 0, sigma V equal to 0, you will get what was the forces in the members. Okay, you need to have the FBD of the joint only when fair there are only 2 unknown member forces are acting. So already you know the procedure. So this is how, consider joint B, consider joint E. So then find out all the forces in the members. So these are the forces in the members. Okay, all the members, total 7 members. So now compute the axial force K in various members due to unit load. So that is virtual force by using method of joints. So now here we are applying 1 kN. So this is 1 kN where the deflection is required. I am applying 1 kN. So what will be the reaction? Symmetrical load 0.5, 0.5. Correct. Then again find what all the forces in the members of the truss by method of joints. So see here, these are the forces in the members of the trusses by method of joints or method of sections. So ultimately, so due to the application of unit force. Okay, so total 7 members, lengths in mm, area in mm², so all are constant. So even length are constant because equilateral triangle. So Young's modulus kN/mm². So it is also same for all the members. So this P due to external, correct? So due to this is external force. These are the forces in the members of the truss. So this is K due to 1 kN. Correct? Due to the application of 1 kN at point E, what all the forces in the members of the trusses by method of joints or method of sections. Then this is the standard formula. Delta is given by PKL by AE, P into K into L by A into E. So in each member, individual member, you are going to calculate. So ultimately, if you add all the deflection in each individual member for the entire truss, compute the summation delta deflection or vertical deflection for the entire truss, that is summation. So you'll be getting the deflection, that is vertical deflection, as 0.10614 mm. 0.10614 mm. Okay, in terms of mm, because we have kept everything in mm, you will be getting 0.10614 mm. Okay, so please do this again. So method of joints, you are aware, or method of sections, make this tabular column. So just it depends on this formula. Okay, similarly, one more type of problem here, in the horizontal load is acting on the inclined member. So the angles are given, the lengths. So this is 6 meters, this is 45, this is 45. So if this is 45, this is 45, this is 45. So ultimately here it should be 90 degrees, correct? So this will be 90, here it will be 90, correct? So this is 90 degrees, this is 90 degrees, 45, 45, 90. So this will be 90. So the find the angles, then again find whatever the dimensions required depending upon the available data. So you can use your trigonometric relations. So here it is asked to find, determine the horizontal deflection of joint C. So here joint C, so horizontal, so 1 kilonewton, the rightwards or leftwards you can assume and go ahead with this. So first, due to the applied external load, step one, find what will be the forces in the members of the truss. Okay, to find the reactions for the applied external force, so using trigonometric equations, so you'll be finding what all the reactions, HA, RA and RD. Okay, so then compute the axial force P due to the external force, that is 60. 60 kilonewton was the load. So due to 60, so consider one by one method of joints, so our method of sections, whichever you are comfortable. So find what all the forces in the members of the trusses. Okay, so if you use the method of joints, you need to consider two forces maximum as the unknown, the FED of a joint where there are only two unknown member forces. Apply sigma H is equal to 0, sigma V equal to 0. So assume the unknown forces as tensile, correct? Go ahead with this procedure for all the members. If you solve the particular problem, find the member forces by a method of sections, so you need to pass a section through the members for the entire truss, cutting members, either it may be a section, may be plane, vertical, horizontal, inclined, so anything, okay, curve, anything is okay, but it has to pass from one end to the other end, entire truss has to be cut. Okay, then you will be using the entire left hand side or right hand side after cutting the section. So you will apply 3 equilibrium conditions, sigma H is equal to 0, sigma V equal to 0 and sigma M equal to 0, that is by method of sections. Okay, so find the forces in the members. Then now, so here the one more step, we need to find the forces in the members of the trusses by application of 1 kilonewton where the deflection is required. So here the deflection is required at point C, so horizontal force we are applying 1 kilonewton, so at point C. So again find the reactions due to 1 kilonewton, remove the load which was acting here, 60 kilonewton. So all the external forces are removed, only 1 kilonewton will be applied. Due to this, what are the reactions? Find the reactions. Then again by method of section or method of joints, find what are the forces in the members of the truss due to the application of 1 kilonewton. Okay, so go ahead with this. So once you find the same tabular column, so total 5 members, lengths, so find all the lengths in terms of mm, so areas and in terms of mm, so Young's modulus in terms of kilonewton per mm square, so then load in kilonewton, so this P is due to the external load, correct? So this is due to external load, this is due to 1 kilonewton. The forces in the members of the truss due to the external load, the forces in the members of the truss due to 1 kilonewton. So this is standard formula, delta is equal to PKL by AE. So ultimately in each individual member, what is the deflection mm? For the entire truss you are finding, so add all the individual displacements. Okay, or deflections, delta you are getting here in this problem, the horizontal deflection as 2.11 mm. Okay, the horizontal deflection here it is 2.11 mm. Okay, so this is how you will solve the truss problem by unit load method or virtual work method. So just go through this all the problems once again, all the truss problems, so frame problems and beam problems by unit load. So they are easy, so you can just go through the procedure and on your own you can find what will be the deflection on beams, frames and trusses. So the method of joints or method of sections, any one particular method, if you are perfect, then it's better to solve by method of joints or method of section with only one particular method. Okay, again, do not solve the same problem by method of joints and method of sections. It will be taking time. So whatever you are practicing, so solve it by any one particular method. Okay, you should be perfect with one particular method and you need to find the forces in the members of the truss. Okay, so we have completed this fourth module, so wherein we have discussed what is strain energy, complementary strain energy, then strain energy due to bending moment, shear force, axial force, correct, the torsion, some derivations we have done. Then again we have solved problems on beams, frames, trusses by strain energy. Again we have solved problems on beams, frames, trusses by Castiglione's theorem. Again we have solved beams, frame, trusses problems by unit load method. Okay, so if you feel any difficulty in either in third module, that is moment area method and conjugate beam method, the problems, or else the fourth module, that is energy principles and energy theorems, so you can contact me with this email, kiranmp@kles.cet.ac.in. okay, so you can feel free to contact me anytime, you can mail me. Okay, let us stop it here. Thank you.